Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to old times. Just got to go and refill this sea drill a minute. The weekly question is, which sugar beet harvester do you want me to use? Do you want me to use the Grimme Topper and Rootster 604? And bear in mind that I know that this is a post-1980s model, but it is similar to models that were used pre-1980, and I can't find any reliable ones. I've tried a few, and I've not been able to find any that work well or are reliable in any way. So I'm going to have to make do with this, and my apologies for that. I realize it's not what we want, but we're going to have to sort of work with it. So do we want to use this one, or do you want me to use this one here, the RKS-4 Sugar Beet Harvester? This is pretty much the same as the potato harvester, so you have seen it in action before, but it's your vote, it's your game. Do you want me to buy the RKS-4 or hire the Grimme Rootster? So, I'm going to fill this one up with canola again, and then we can let it carry on sowing. The cultivator is doing a grand job, and he's cultivating away. I haven't done anything else since the last episode. We're going to cut down some more trees today and sell them. And there was something else that I have gone and got. I've got the mod for it. It's ready to go. It costs an absolute fortune. It's got to be the most expensive mod I have ever seen. And I'll just show it to you a second. Now, I realize that this isn't exactly a pre-1980s one, but it is similar to the sort of thing that you would have had. And it's this one, the Beast. Okay. Now, this is kind of slightly more modern, but what it's essentially is several big crushers all in there, and you drop the logs in on top, it crushes them into wood chips, which they go into a little storage tank. Actually, the storage tank's here at the front. And from there, they siphon off into a trailer. And there would have been things like this around, probably not quite on this scale, but wood crushers have been around since the 1880s. Okay, so they've been around for a long time. And the only other ones that I could find are more like the Jens wood chipper that is in the standard game, which is here. Yeah, let me show you. Right, they're more like this one, and this is a much more modern version of a wood chipper. So whereas that one on the lorry, yes, it is really, really big, and it sort of aspects of it are definitely newer, but I think overall it is actually more kind of fitting with an older map, because a wood chipper isn't something that farmers would have had. It was quite an expensive piece of kit, and so it would have been more common for a specialized rig to go to different places and be used. I mean, you wouldn't really have used wood chips on farms anyway. It would have been a very specialist type of operation. I guess you would have used them in forestry work. I don't really know. I don't know much about forestry work, I'm afraid. But I'm thinking that one is quite accurate, as accurate as we're going to get. However, did you notice a price tag at €750,000? Okay, it's a little bit expensive, and it costs €60,000 to rent. And then you've got to get the lorry to pull it, which is another 15. It's actually over that. So we're actually looking at €80,000 to hire it and use the machine. So it will be a one-off. It's not something that I'm going to be doing very often. But I would like to try it, because it's the best example of a wood chipper that I could find that would have been a mobile station that would have been carried around, transported to different locations, set up, and then used for an extended period of time. So that is the one that I would like to use, and if you really, really don't like it and you think that it is horribly inaccurate, I do apologize for that, but we're just going to sort of have to live with it. Right, let's turn this one on. And, oh no, I need to be in the cab, don't I? Oh, that one. I want to open the door. There we go. Have the door open for running this machine, and I'm not going to try and run it from in there. Should I try and get those by the river, or go for these up here? I'm going to go for one of these up here for now, and let's turn that one off now. Right, I will try and do one from in the cab, although I don't think I'm going to have much luck with this, because of... Oh, there we go. We can turn it around like that. There we go. And... Right, the joystick... My actual joystick works on this one, which is a little bit weird, considering that the joystick doesn't work on the one that it's actually supposed to be working on. Right, let's open that one up. We need to change the length of the log. I was going to attempt to do a 15-meter length branch just to see if we could tip it into the water down there. I don't think we're going to have much luck with this, but we will try. Now then, I can do those two movements with the joystick. And they are back to front. Okay, I'm going to have to come out of cab because I can't judge that. Well, it should actually be just about right. Turn it a bit. There we go. There. Right, now I'll come back in cab now that it's judged. There we go. Slice. And let's lift that and I'll move this way. Okay. Ah, that's because I'm doing it the wrong way. This thing is back to front. That's what's making it so difficult. Right, let's do it with the mouse, and I'm going to have to come out of cab a second so that I can at least get it to sort of go to a safe position. I'll drag it back this way a little bit. There. Right, now let's try and slice that at 15 meter lengths. I don't think our machine is going to pick that up. Oh, look at that thing. It's huge. Right, is it going to actually let me cut the other one, or is it just going to drop it and say, no, you can't have it? Oh, no, it is. It did actually cut it. Right, I'm going to move, and I'm going to... I want to go backwards because I'm facing... I'm going to move this one down here. And the reason being is I want to use it to block that log if we need to. So let's just shut... That's a brilliant sound when it shuts off. That's really good. Right. Now we're going to hop into this one. And I got a feeling that we're not going to be able to move a 15-meter log down through here. I just don't think it's going to fit. Okay, let's start her up. And we will attempt to do this from in cab, but again, I don't think it's going to work, as I just can't see enough to be successful. Oh, I might be able to see a little bit. Right, let's come up there. Close you round that. You right up back like that. There we go. Right, I can't see anything. Not properly, and... Okay, we're not... Oops. Whoa, what are you doing, Frith? Right, that's not balanced very well. It's putting undue strain on every part of the machine. It's not going to fit, is it? It's just not going to fit. Okay, if we can come through there, we might be able to... Hopefully it's not going to, like, launch off like that bale did at the beginning of the week in Melbury Estate. Although, if this was a real-life machine, my boss would be swearing at me right now. Or if I was working for myself, I would be swearing at this branch. Because look at what it's doing to that grab. It's really twisting it round, isn't it? But we have made it to the river. Okay, it looks like holding this thing like this is the way to go, actually. Now, if I can twist it like that, that's going to force it round. Twist it a little bit further. Right, how much are we going to get for this? Go, go, go. No, 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 no. Oh, that's no good. How am I supposed to get that? Oh, great. Look, it's stuck behind the wood there. Can I reach? Can I reach? If I go forward too far, I'm going to end up driving off the edge, aren't I? Got it! 5,881. and if we had it half that length, we'd have gotten both of them for about 4,000. So it's not worth cutting one at 15 meters, it would seem. It would seem that's a complete and utter waste of time. So I think we're going to have to get the old chainsaw out, and we don't actually have a chainsaw at the moment, though, do we? We're going to need to buy a chainsaw so that we can chop that one in half, and then we can carry them both. Let me just hop off of here a second. And, right. We're going to have to buy a chainsaw. There we go. Right, we have a chainsaw. We're gonna need a chainsaw anyway. Technically, I should have run over to the shop and picked that up, but let's just imagine that I have. So rather than me actually having to cut, get the chainsaw, come back again, we've done it already. Okay, we'll just call it that, and then everybody's happy, I hope. Now then, there we go. I cut that one in half right there. That should then be enough. Let's cut in half. Right, put the chainsaw away. Now let's get you, and we'll pick these logs up. Right, I'm going to take these three logs over, and then come back to you when I move up into there, and we start cutting a few more down. I'm going to use the chainsaw to cut some of these other ones down, but those we're going to be chucking into that beast chipper tomorrow. That is the plan for tomorrow, if we have enough money to rent the thing, and I'm not sure it's actually going to be worth it. I don't know. But anyway, I'm going to get some of these over and tipped into the water. See if we can get a bit of money from them. I am just doing one here from in cab, just so that we can see it. And I don't want to go any further. Let's just quickly check where we are. Right. So that's where we are on the actual machine. But then when we look inside, it looks different. Right. Let's do that. That one there. That rolls out. We get 600 for that little one. Okay. Right. Cannot see a thing with this machine. I understand now what people mean when they said this thing was horrible to drive, very poor visibility. It was also extremely hot. You've got no... You had little windows that you could open on the side. I mean, you often had... I think they had the windows on the front open as well. But yeah, it wasn't very comfortable. Anyway, I got work to do. I'm just topping up this one again. And then we'll head back down to the forest and we'll do some more work. That tree, altogether, we've got now up to 25,000. Considering it's going to cost 80,000 euros to hire that beast for the wood chipping, I'm having second thoughts about that. That seems like an awful lot of money to spend this early in the game on a one-off. And the wood chips that we can sell from doing that isn't going to make us a huge amount of money either. So I'm thinking actually I'm going to postpone that. So I do apologize for getting your hopes up yet again on something and then failing to deliver. But I am going to fail to deliver on that one, and I may even put the usage of the beast on this map to a vote to everyone here. Let it be your decision. The canola has started sprouting here, and I think I'm going to have to do several refills with this one. This is the slightly annoying thing about having this hired help consumes the seeds add-on. Is that they actually consume the seeds. Yeah. Okay, let me get back over to the forest. Right, I'm taking this one up into the trees up here, and we're going to cut down three or four trees, and we do seem to be getting a reasonable amount per tree, so it's not too bad. And once I've gotten three or four trees, and that'll probably be nearly it, we will sell a few of them, and we'll start off with this one here. But once I've gotten several trees, right, I want to put that one there and that one down like that. I need to turn the machine on. It's going to be time to buy some animals, I think, because we haven't actually bought any animals yet. So that is something that we're going to need to do. Well, I suppose we've bought chickens, but I want more than just chickens. I want sheep and I want cattle. Now, the annoying thing with this is I keep getting directions wrong. So if I let it fall that way, there we go. And we come into cab so that we can see our counter. I do not want 15 meter lengths. We're going to go for 8 meters because that seems to be the sweet spot as far as the length of tree is. So let's slice through a few of these. So we're going to get some sheep. At the moment, we've got enough money to buy 10 cows, actually. But I don't think I'm going to get any cows just yet. I think I'll get sheep first. And I'd like to get enough money to get 100 sheep. I think 100 would be a good start. It's not masses of sheep, but we should at least then, with 100 sheep, get at least a pallet of wool per day. Maybe more than that. I don't know if we'll get more than a pallet per day. Lift that one up and bring that down. Like I said, this is really difficult because it's back front. And it's also very, very difficult to judge distances in this game. Because obviously you're trying to do a three-dimensional distance with a two-dimensional game. Which does make things a little bit difficult. Now, if I can just swing that one out, there we go. Right. Now I'll slide him back that way just a fraction. And we'll cut again. Okay, I think I just shoved the end of the tree right off there. Let me come out of cab now so we have a... Yeah, so I've chucked a couple of them. I'll go and get that one there. But 100 sheep to start with, and that will get us some wool. And we should hopefully get enough money as well that we can get a... We want to buy a mower. The mower, I think, is 8,000 to buy. Even though it's a little sidebar finger mower. And you wouldn't have thought that that would set us back 8,000 euros. But yeah, apparently it does. So we're just going to have to live with that, unfortunately. Even though it's not the cheapest machine. Right, that tree is going that way. So let's go with it. There we go. Cut that one again. There we go. We can see better now. I like to be able to see what I'm doing properly. One of the things that I do like is to be able to look at it properly. I would love to actually see a real Pika Model 75 working. I think that would be such an awesome sight to see. Because, I mean, those machines were way ahead of their time. They really were. So there's three of them. Let's cut down one more. And then we can start tipping a couple into the water. Just line that one up. Swing him in. There we go. Slice. Now if I drag it back over there like that. I'm going to turn a bit. Drag it back that way. There we go. Oop, wrong way. There we go. Now let's slice this one off. There's quite a few there. It would be nicer if I could get a bigger front-end loader machine. So that I could pick up more branches in one go rather than just doing one. Unless I got a very small branch, I can only pick up one at a time. There's some front-end loaders, some new ones, that pick up loads of stuff, which is fantastic, but we can't do that right now. So let's turn this machine off. Gotta shut the door from the front there. Climb out. Oops, no, I didn't want to do that. There we go. Right, so we've got a pile of logs. Let's go and get our loader. Where is it? There it is. And so we'll start selling these. I will finish selling these between now and next episode so that we've got some money. And I think we are going to go and buy some sheep. Probably done enough forestry work for now. I've cut down several trees and made a pile of money out of it. And it is handy to know that we can get that one again. I mean, how much is that thing? I wonder if it would be worth actually buying it. Forestry equipment, there, that one, 86,000. That one I think would actually be a good investment. I think it would be worth buying that one. And then this one here takes the shorter logs. I don't know how short a log it will take though. Up to 7 meters. And that's up to 6 meters. So we could do 7 meter logs and put them on there. And then again, but there's no way to tip them with that one. This one, yeah, never mind that. And then this one here, you can use for 8 to 15 meter. You sort of put it on the back of that one and it takes the longer logs. It does work really well, that one. I did test that one. and I was quite pleased with it. Right, how many of these logs am I actually going to carry if I pick them up? Just the one by the look of it. That one is going to drop off in just a second. Almost certain of it. Yeah, there he goes. Right, let's drag this one over. And we are running out of time, so I am going to tip all of these logs between now and next episode. My driving is terrible here. There we go. And it's twisting that top bar again. So, yeah, I've got that beast thing. It is ready to be used, but I think we're not going to use it now because it's going to cost 80 grand to be able to use it, and I think that is a little bit excessive considering we only have 29,000 at the moment. So I'm going to use some of this money to buy sheep, and if we get enough from these four, I may even buy some cows, but I probably won't. We'll probably have another session of forestry work in a little while, so that we can... Now, where did that log go? I got a little log right there. Let me grab that one. Yeah, we'll have another forestry session in a little while to make enough money to buy some cows, and we will go for at least 20 cows to start with. So that's going to be 50,000 pounds. Not pounds, euros. Right, let's pick you up. There you go. Can I get another small log onto this one? We'll just try to get a small log onto this one, and it doesn't really matter if I can. I'm going to be tipping all of these into the water before we start our next episode, because we're going to get sheep next episode. That is what we're going to do. Which way do you want to go? That way. Right, now put you down like that. Right, problem. This grab doesn't seem to like more than one at a time. Even those little ones. Look at that. I got that little one right there. It's just not gonna get it. Oh, I got it. I got a bigger log there as well. Hopefully that one will drop off. It's not gonna force the others out, is it? It's gonna come with me. Oh, this game does some funny things, doesn't it? Right, okay. I wonder if I can actually get that into the river. Three at once. Go on. We're nearly there. It's gonna fall off right on that log pile, isn't it? No, stop. Oh, I nearly drove right in. I got too keen. I nearly drove right in there. Right, let me tip that down. That's just gonna stop there, that log, isn't it? Right, I can chuck those two in. And that one is stuck there, so I got to manoeuvre around and just shove it in. But it is over here at least, so that's a start. Yeah, so the question for this week is, do you want me to get the Grimme Rootster sugar beet harvester with the topper? I will rent those two if we're going to get those. Or do you want me to buy the, it's in here, the RKS-4 sugar beet harvester? Do you want me to buy that one or hire the Grimme Rootster? The reason is we got to buy that one because we don't have the option to rent it. So, it's your vote, it's your game. Which one do you want me to use? There we go, there's another one, there's another 2,000. I think we're going to be able to get our sheep. We might even be able to go as many as 150 sheep. That would be fantastic if we could do that. We're going to have to do a load of mowing and foraging and stuff like that soon. So, if you enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later. Come on. Just want to get one last log on the forks before I go. There we go. Go on. Up. Ugh. Okay, yeah. Okay, bye.